Oh, damn. There you go, right on there.
Mm. How's the wind, bro?
Almost gone.
I go on and on, can't understand how I last so long. I must have superpowers.
Ladies and gentlemen,
what's up, motherfuckers?
Handsome, I'm fast, I'm pretty, and can't possibly be beat.
Almost gone?
Almost gone.
Take a look at him.
We got the,
What you got there?
The grilled teriyaki.
Grilled teriyaki?
Mm-hmm.
I got the sweet chili garlic. So it's Thursday. Wings day.
Wing night. And these are good.
This wing is good. These are really good.
We got them from that place. Are we mentioning the names?
It's across the street.
It's not across town, but it is across the street.
Across the street.
I'm gonna go fly.
So good. So good.
You know, good. You know what goes good with wings?
What's that?
Bud Light.
Dilly Dilly.
Bud Light Dilly Dilly.
Dilly Dilly.
Dilly Dilly. Dilly.
You know what else goes good with it? Modelo Negro.
Modelo.
Rhode R.
Modelo.
Don't forget the Rhode R.
That's all I'm saying is Modelo.
Modelo Negro.
Cheers,
baby.
Cheers, brother. I'm trying not to get myself a clown face with all this sauce, though.
Right. Ben. We got KT's, KT Quarantine, Day Drinkers.
Day Drinkers. Still daylight.
It's still daylight.
That's it.
Open bar.
Open bar. Seriously, Bud Light, if you're watching, throw some of that sponsor dollars our way.
So something we can appreciate. We would appreciate it.
Oh, man.
My brother.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Good, man. How are you?
Another week, another dollar.
Another week, another dollar. So, listen. How has your week been?
My week, it's pretty normal actually. I was back at work most of the time, so
okay.
A lot back to normal as far as work wise goes.
Okay.
But then you get home and still kids can't do nothing.
Right.
You ain't going nowhere.
We gotta entertain the motherfuckers. Yeah. I don't get it. Listen, man, have you been watching the news lately?
I try not to.
Okay.
But yeah.
Listen,
I'm aware of what's going on.
What do you think about the COVID-19 cases that are going back up and through the roof? And now they shut us down. They gave us some freedom. Now they're trying to take it away again. How do you feel about that, man?
Man, it's a roller coaster because it's like, yeah, you think things are going good, then
right.
They spike back up.
Right.
But, you know, you hear what I was reading something today about a bunch of kids having, like, COVID parties.
Right.
It's like, how stupid, you know, I'm ready to be out hanging with my friends, drinking beer, but I'm not ready to be
Thursday like, eating wings.
Exactly, but I'm not like trying to be around hundreds and thousands of people.
Right.
You know, swappings, sharing food. And
right.
I would say swap and spit, but I don't swap spit with,
well, right.
with nobody anymore.
Unless
except one person.
Oh boy, he spit on you. What was the guy?
Oh, Jason Newsted? Yeah, see, I wouldn't be happy with that right now.
Right? You whoop his ass, wouldn't you?
I mean, I didn't almost get the swine flu like Katie, but, you know, it still spit beer on me.
Right, and Katie, that was Marilyn Manson, right?
I believe that is correct.
I think Katie lied about that story. I think the Marilyn Manson, like, slobbered down, man.
Man, the one thing I think
he said, "Come here, woman. Come here, woman.
Hey, woman. Listen here.
got no heart. Maybe you like to see a real man. I bet you stay up late every night dreaming you had a real man, don't you? I tell you what, bring your pretty little self over to my apartment tonight, and I'll show you a real man.
What was this talking about, Rocky III? Mr. T. Yeah. I think Katie went over there willingly. I don't think, I don't think he spit on her.
Marilyn Manson doesn't sound like Mr. T.
We're going to ask Katie about that when she get over here. I don't, because, oh, we forgot. Katie's our co-host. She's a bartender here. She's actually the lovely lady that made this happen at Miss Kitty's. We love it here.
I'll tell you the one thing I found positive with all the COVID stuff.
Yeah.
From what I've been seeing anyway, it's like from what I've read, like the cases are, they're spiking up.
Yeah.
But like the mortality rate, death rates are still down here.
Okay.
But I think that's like playing with fire though. It's like, you know.
I agree.
So right now those are still down low, but just more. Yeah, I guess if you don't test them, you don't have.
Right.
If you don't test them, you can't get it. But
right.
But my beacon of hope in there is that like the death rates are still low. But yeah, I think it's a dangerous game to be playing.
It's definitely a dangerous game, man. And recently, oh, my cat hair, man. Soup, I love you. She cat hair every damn where, man. Listen, so I went to Florida a couple of weeks ago, and. Right. Florida, man, it's like they don't give a shit about COVID. It's like, what's a COVID?
That's why I'm nervous sitting next to you.
Man, fuck you, Gus. Man, fuck you, Gus. Man, fuck you, Gus. At least I hope I don't. Knock on some damn wood. But no, for real, man, we were going out to restaurants. Man, the only person that had a mask on was the dude who was taking our order.
Yeah, the people that worked there.
No, he was just him.
Oh, just him.
It was just his ass, man. Nobody else, man. So, I don't know, man. Florida, man, they was off the chain. They didn't give no fucks.
You just gotta be smart. I mean, like I said, I'm not living my life in a bubble, but I'm bringing hand sanitizer with me. I got my mask.
Where's your hand sanitizer at, man?
Would you like to see it? You don't believe me?
I don't believe us. I think he lying to us.
Yeah, man. Boom. Refill it.
Let me get some of that hand sanitizer, man. Get some of this shit. What is this?
Oh, that's my work logo, but.
Okay.
But I got one of the big refillable bottles that runs out. Pop it back in.
You ever use this shit like on cuts and shit? Like whatever you have.
If you have a cut, it'll find it.
It'll find the shit out the cut.
Paper cut, you'd be like.
Find the shit out there. Absolutely. But now I just use it on the cuts, man.
Right there. Right there, I have one. I was like,
hell yeah.
It burns.
So, hey, man. So, last week, we brought in the artist. It was a great show. We're happy that the artist, he's part of the
artist was like, he was feeling the camera. He was looking into your soul going, it's okay. You can get up and sing if you want to. Believe in yourself. I mean, that's what he said.
Absolutely. I was motivated. I was about to grab the damn mic and start going.
Speaking of.
Yeah.
Tonight.
What's tonight?
At Miss Kitty's.
What's tonight?
It's the return of, we call Karaoke.
Karaoke.
Karaoke at Miss Kitty's. Karaoke.
Yes.
I'm excited and a little nervous just because it's still the corona shit all out there. You know, you don't want people using the same microphone, but I'll tell you what, I'll go up, I'll sing, I won't come back, hand sanitizer, boom, boom, boom.
So, hold on one second.
Get in here, Kate.
Katie, the lovely Katie. Yes, yes, yes. Yay! So Katie says we have
a solution to that, actually. I went and bought sandwich bags. You know, like the kind you go your weed in. I bought 600 of them. Two packs of 300. It cost me $7.50, and everyone can just put a new bag on in between, you know, at every song. So okay. When you're singing, you have the bag over, then you take it off. Next person come, put the bag on.
Genius.
Right? And hopefully genius. It doesn't
so,
distort the sound.
In other words, we're going to wrap them. We're going to wrap that rascal.
Well, you need to, you know, just right. Just put it,
gotta wrap
know,
it up.
Cover
gotta
it.
Wrap it up.
So
wrap
that
up.
Way your spittle comes off with the bag.
Maybe that's right. Maybe that's something guys tell each other. Make sure you wrap it.
Right. Wrap it up.
Really? I wish you guys would say that
a little
more. I have a damn IUD because you motherfucker.
Wait, so we were saying too, so Marilyn Manson, he's, what story again? He got sick right after he spit on
you? He sprayed Bud Light on the whole crowd, or Budweiser, it was a bottle of Budweiser all over the whole crowd at the rave in Milwaukee.
Okay.
And like a day or two later, he was canceled the whole rest of his tour. Because he had swine flu, which is a form of the coronavirus.
I like how but we like both leaned up in the same
right, right, right. We both have questions. We both have questions.
I have answers.
You want to ask your question first?
And then I just spilled. I have a drinking problem.
got a hole in this chin. You want to ask?
You
want to ask?
I drink and I know things.
We only get it's Katie, you know, sporadically, so we got to ask our questions serious. While she's here. You have a question to ask Katie?
I can't believe I spilled beer on myself. No, man.
We'll edit that.
I'm too embarrassed to ask my question now. Go ahead.
Okay, so the word on the street is you was a backstage groupie for Marilyn Manson. He slobbed you down.
There's some whores in this house. There's some whores in this house. There's some whores in this house.
I said certified freak. 7 days a week.
I wish. I would tell that.
There's
story,
no, there's
that
no, there's
true.
No truth to that. Are you sure?
Only in my dreams, as a teenager and in my early 20s. Now he's a little bit.
Oh,
know.
Marilyn.
I do love his music, though. I'm a big Marilyn fan.
We are stars now.
We're all stars now. In the dope show. We're all stars now. In the dope show.
In the dope show. I don't even know if I got the lyrics right.
Yeah,
actually,
no, you
my
got
favorite,
it right.
My favorite Marilyn Manson song would be Beautiful People. That's just like.
Now that album. Exactly. That whole album is one of my favorite.
Kind of like we were talking about before. That's just like a good driving song.
It is. That's a dope song.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think. So tell us about that concert. Was it dope?
Yeah, I've seen Marilyn Manson like 6 or 7 times.
Okay.
How many times? How many times did he spit on you?
The right. Only, well, maybe a couple of times. But that
how many
was the
times
only
did he slap
time
you down?
Like, cause I'll if I can.
How many
I'll
times
did
he slap
the
you
front.
Down?
Maybe 2 or 3.
Let me slap you down.
Now you're making me turn red. I'm too Irish for that.
Oh, was that Ready for the World or?
I was Ready for the World.
Ready for the World. Dang.
Dang.
Yeah, I ain't ready for this. So listen, man. I'm excited about karaoke tonight.
It's back. I'm excited.
It is back, and not that I'm a lead singer. I am a backup, but I enjoy it, man.
You're a great hype man.
Thank you. I appreciate that. But I enjoy it.
It's fun. It's a time, fun man. Night.
What are we singing? What are we singing tonight,
what
Gus?
What are we singing tonight?
Lovely day. Lovely day.
Lovely
day.
Choice,
lovely
bit,
day.
I want you to put your hands together and welcome him to the stage. Big round of applause for Jackson Heights' own.
This is very special right here. We got sexual chocolate. We got white chocolate, of course. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Dave in the house. This one is special. Y'all might want to get y'all cameras out. Get y'all cameras out for this. I'm just saying. This might go viral. Ladies and gentlemen. All right. Yes.
Look, man.
I'm in between greatness here. We got Dr. Dave. We got white chocolate. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, sexual chocolate.
When I wake up in the morning, love,
all right.
And the sunlight hurts my eyes. Something without warning, love. Heavy on my mind. When I look at you, the whole world's alright with me.
Alright, that's right.
Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be
what's gonna be, Gus?
A
everyone.
I wait someone else instead of me. Always seem to know the way. Then I look at you.
Okay.
And the world's all right with me.
All right. That's right.
Hey, just one look at you.
All right, Katie, I see you over there.
And I know it's gonna be.
It's gonna be Dr. Dre.
Help me out, brother. A lovely day.
Lovely day.
Lovely day. Lovely day. It's a lovely day.
Okay.
Someone else is scared of me.
I like when he does that.
They always seem to know the way. Then I look at you. If the world's alright with me.
Okay. Okay.
Just wanna look at you.
Alright. We got Dr. Dave over here, y'all.
And I know it's going to be.
What is it gonna be, brother?
Lovely day. We got to, because it's a lovely
and
day.
The weather's,
like,
yeah.
Besides the fact it's a lovely day outside today.
It is. There ain't no sunshine, but there is sunshine.
There is sunshine.
So, no sunshine, yeah. When she's
gone. You
gotta
do that one in the wintertime. Exactly. Lovely day in the summer.
I sing ain't no sunshine when it's like dark and gray and something shitty happens.
When your wife leaves for the weekend.
That's cool in the gang celebration. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
We definitely got to cut that part out.
We're not cutting that shit.
Kill you.
Are you kidding me?
We're not.
She might be on the show next week.
We should have her on the show.
Fuck you, Mom.
This might be my last show.
No, we're going to bring her on.
This might be your last karaoke, too, if you keep talking like that.
You can go celebrate with your friends.
Yeah, you can celebrate with your friends. Then go ahead.
Oh, man.
I love it, man. Right. I love it. So, we're singing Lovely Day today, tonight.
I'm sure, yeah.
Okay.
I'm sure we'll do that.
What else?
I don't know. Try to see if Silent D shows up. We'll see.
Listen, country songs.
He does.
Country, Whiskey Girl.
He's a brother that sings country music. Yeah, now, I love
that's
it.
That's all he sings.
Don't get me wrong. I love it.
Silent D, if you don't start showing up, Calvin says he's going to steal it.
I'm going to steal Whiskey Girl. She's my little whiskey girl. I'm going to kick my leg up like Silent D does. Y'all know when he kicks his leg up? My skin,
yeah,
you know what I'm talking
like
about.
Like a belt buckle and cowboy boots and a hat and all that.
What was that dude's name?
Lil Nas X.
You come walking in like Lil Nas.
Lil Nas X.
How dare you? That will be funny as hell.
I would do that funny. Song.
No, I don't care about the song. I want you to come in dressed like. I want you to look. I want you coming in with a look.
Got the horses in the back.
I just want him coming in with a cowboy hat and
Old Town Road.
Look
at
Mikey Connell.
Old Town Road.
Yeah, Old Town Road.
Oh, I'll do the shit out that song. I'm gonna do the shit out that song, and I'm gonna wear the costume.
Didn't they give him an award, a CMT award, a gay black man, a country music award?
Yes.
I'm pretty sure they did.
They did.
Good and for you,
Billy
CMT.
Ray. Billy Ray did that song with him, right? Billy Ray Cyrus?
I think he had the cameo in there, yeah.
Look, man, Billy Ray a bad motherfucker.
Feature.
Chirp.
I like Billy Ray, man. Yeah. I like Billy Ray, man. He's dope ass.
Katie, I don't.
See, you know Billy Ray.
Miley Cyrus' stepdad.
That's right, Hannah Montana.
That's her stepdad?
I think he adopted her.
I thought that was her diddy.
I don't think it biologically. I think he adopted her. I could be wrong, but Katie got all that. I win a lot of trivia. So
okay,
I'm
next
say
week.
I'm not.
Next podcast, we want the answer.
Okay. We'll Google it right now.
Right.
Google it right now, YouTube. Tell us.
No, we're going
what's the answer?
We're going to have my man, Black of the Berry, Sweeter the Juice, Google it.
The darker the flesh, the deeper the root.
Yeah. That's some
Pac. It is Pac. I love Pac.
I'm telling you right now, Katie is deep.
That out too.
Katie is deep.
I love Pac.
I put Pac as in my
so
top
much.
Five.
He's a poet of our lifetime.
Yeah. Pac is dope. But I got a question for you guys. We kind of touched on this last week, and we said we'll circle back and talk about it this week. Your top five celebrity crushes. That shit's easy for me. I see them every morning.
On your wall?
In my mind. Just ingrained in my mind. So you got to know your top five celebrity crushes. It's probably all the Kardashians, man.
No, none of them.
Even the mama.
Both of them.
Don't.
Which one?
Both the mamas.
Let me tell you something, man. The mama of the Kardashians, she fine. Stop it. Stop playing.
Plastic surgery will do that, though.
You can't get shit over all Katie.
I'm just saying. If she was broke, she wouldn't look like that.
I need to come
none
back.
None of them would.
I need to come
none
back.
None of them would.
I need to come back to that one.
You want me to start?
No. Sure, yeah.
Or Katie could start.
I don't really care about celebrities. I mean, I love Brad Pitt like my whole life. He's
right.
Sexy.
Okay.
I don't know.
You like David Bowie in the Labyrinth.
I do.
You like
David
you like,
Bowie, period, but he's so
you like
tiny.
His, you like his skinny ass
crush.
Pants. You like the little.
He definitely stuffed his crotch.
You like
his like spandex. It's like spandex.
Right. You see how excited she got. Okay, that's two.
That's my best Eddie Murphy. That's horrible.
Damn.
I don't know. Angelina Jolie, she's hot. I liked when they were together. I thought that would be like world's best threesome.
That would have been your fantasy threesome?
Yeah, that would have been my fantasy threesome
and,
for sure.
Brad Pitt and Angelina
Jolie.
Yeah,
that's your fantasy
threesome?
Brad
Pitt and Angelina. Yeah.
Okay.
The Brangelina.
All right.
KT Brangelina.
Brangelina
AT. I don't know how that would work.
Okay. I think Gus went to go take a piss.
Thinking went to go take a piss.
Oh, never mind. He's back. So
that was the fastest pee ever.
I'm the fastest pee in the West.
Yeah. You didn't have to do it right there and make a puddle. I got to clean that shit, guys.
No, I just noticed the music got quite a bit louder than what it was just a second ago. It's like,
It did.
I'm hoping people can still hear us.
They can. These mics are pretty good, man. You know, we're talking into the mics.
I worry about
stage
the product.
One. I can let my coworker cat know.
It's all good. Katie, what's your other two?
I don't know. I honestly don't.
You want me to give mine and then we come back?
Yeah, I don't really. I mean, there's so many beautiful people.
The beautiful people.
Yeah, I mean, I like what he has and what he stands for. He's not very attractive.
Okay.
Even with the makeup and fake titties. I mean, I still love him, though. His exes are all hot. Dita Von Teese and Rose McGowan.
That's her.
Rose McGowan. She's coming out with this whole Me Too thing. She's basically
naked at the...
Yeah. It was like a very sheer, like chains.
Yes.
She's a big reason for the Me Too movement, too. She's come out. She was one of the very first people to come out against Harvey Weinstein and what he's done and what he's been doing.
Okay.
And she did an interview with Frank Sinatra's son. What's his name? Rowan. Mia Farrow. Rowan Farrow. Do you guys know about this? This is a juicy thing.
Okay.
So he's actually legally Mia Farrow and Woody, the bad one. Who's the
Woody
bad
Allen.
One? Woody Allen's child. But Frank Sinatra was her first husband, and they had a love affair throughout all the years. And then they've admitted now, all these years later, that Rowan is actually biologically Frank Sinatra's and not Woody Allen.
That's
Get
fucked up.
Get out of it's, here.
And, that's
and
fucked
look
up.
Look at a picture. Look
he probably
at a picture.
Paid all that child support all these days.
All that. But, I mean, he also left Mia Farrow to marry the 13-year-old. Adopted child.
Well, that's
so
weird.
I mean, that's if you think she was fucked up for sleeping with Frank Sinatra, when
that's different levels.
Right. I mean, they all. Right. But if you look at a picture of Rowan Farrow and look at a picture of Frank Sinatra,
look just
that's
alike.
That's his son. I mean, it's true.
I did it my way.
He got the same blue eyes.
I did it my way to her and to her and to her. I did them all, baby.
I did not know any of that. That's crazy
it's not
as
very
hell.
Well known. But
that's
it's
some Hollywood shit.
Yeah, I'm really good with useless trivia.
I love it, man.
Yeah. As you can see by my Miley Cyrus and
Billy Ray Cyrus. I didn't know none of that shit.
Yeah. That's why I win trivia games. I love going to trivia, like any trivia. I'm always like the pop culture person.
Okay.
I've won all kinds of shit. Won gift certificates, a cooler. One time we won a surfboard, our whole group. There's only four of us. We live in Chicago. We don't need no fucking surfboard.
We do not.
We do not. It was the most useless thing we won. But hey, we still won it.
Do you still have it?
No. We gave it to one of the guys, and I think he sent it out to California or I don't know what happened to it. I don't know.
Gotcha.
It was a bullshit win, though.
Praise
what
yourself.
Are four people in Chicago going to do with one surfboard? I like it better. They usually give gift certificates. Most places will get you got 25 $50, $100, whatever.
Yeah.
And that we actually use because then it'll pay for our whole meal and drinks during the trivia.
Nothing wrong with that.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna give you my top five.
All right. I'm working on mine. I got four of my five. So.
My top five, easy, man. In no particular order after this beautiful lady. Number one, Jennifer Lopez.
Yeah, she's gorgeous. Dink.
Fine as hell.
Yeah.
Absolutely fine, man. Still.
Still, yeah.
And what is she,
how do you 50? Feel about her and
she's
A-Rod?
She's at least 50.
J-Rod.
Listen, man, I don't got no problems with A-Rod.
I think they're a really cute couple. It seems like they finally found people that are someone that to love them. Although I thought her and Mark Anthony were a beautiful couple, too.
Right.
But they seem to click. They seem really happy.
They do. And I love the fact that, you know, I don't hate on him. He was a great athlete.
Mm-hmm.
He made a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
He's a great business mind. I mean, the dude's he's doing the damn thing. And he's doing J-Lo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She fine as hell, man.
Yeah, she's gorgeous.
I love her. Man, as a matter of fact, man, she got her start in Living Color.
Yes, she did.
Classic show.
Fly Girl. In Living Color.
All right.
I love the win.
Who do you have for
number two? Number two. You guys probably know her from the Rush Hour movies. Rosalind Sanchez.
Yeah, dank.
Man. Rosalind Sanchez.
I ain't got no complaints there.
She's the reason why I drink Mexican beer. Or Spanish beer, Latin beer. I mean, she might be Puerto Rican. I think she's Puerto Rican.
Then it'd be rum.
Right.
Yeah, start drinking rum.
I drink all that shit. Rosalind Sanchez, number two.
PR, shout out.
Number three. And this one, it might surprise you, but I think she's gorgeous, man. Jennifer Garner. Something about her with those damn Capital One commercials. She fine as hell. Jennifer Garner.
I got no dink on that one.
She fine. I don't know what Ben Affleck was doing, but Jennifer Garner fine, dude.
Isn't she in a Ben Affleck 2 now? Isn't there? I think she dated another Ben. Maybe I'm wrong.
She need to date me. She needs to watch this podcast to date me.
Callan Furr.
I love her, man. Absolutely love her.
Number four.
It's got to be. And you guys, you might be surprised on this one too. Liz Hurley.
Double dink.
Love Liz Hurley. She fine as hell.
Her husband cheated on her, right?
With dumb.
The nanny or a prostitute?
What
someone.
The hell? What the hell was his name?
That was back in the 90s.
That was back in the day. What's his name?
We did this.
Something
Grant.
English.
Hugh Grant.
Dumbass Grant.
Right.
Love her, man. She. What is she almost 60? Is she almost 60? She looks amazing still.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah.
Love her. Beautiful.
I'm with you on that.
Call me.
Is that number? That's four.
That's four.
That's four.
Number five.
Number five. Absolutely love this lady. Halle Berry.
Halle Berry's gorgeous.
Dink.
Fine as hell.
I've got so many beautiful people.
Berry.
There's so many beautiful people.
But these are the ones I consistently think about.
People. See, and I don't think about any of them until I watch something and I'm like, oh, yeah.
On a daily basis. Like my man Theus said, on a daily basis. Like, I can see myself going with them.
So you watch Swordfish like over and over and over.
Ooh, Swordfish is. I have that DVD.
That scene, the one scene. Oh, my God. She's so hot.
She's so hot.
She's so beautiful.
She's fine as hell. I don't know why she can't keep a man. There's got to be something wrong.
Because hot girls are crazy.
Crazy as fuck. Y'all know Katie crazy too, right?
Crazy for
the crazy is fun, right?
Right, crazy is fun. But that's my top five. All right.
Gus. I got my five.
What's your five?
And you actually took one of them. So I'm going number one. Again, no particular order, but just number one because you said Elizabeth Hurley.
Mm.
She's up there too.
Mm-hmm. What you like about her? You want to lick the salt off her body, don't you?
Her curves.
Man, you're going to lick the salt off your ass,
y'all
girl.
Gonna get, y'all going to get me in trouble. No, but yeah, no, I just say it's
all entertainment.
And still, I mean, even today, she looks amazingly.
Amazing.
And
absolutely amazing.
I don't, and the voice probably too. That Bedazzled movie.
Yeah. She was the devil.
Forget about it.
Yes.
Yeah. Number two, I'm going to go probably... My first celebrity crush from when I was Lil Gus. Not to be confused with Lil Nas, but Lil Gus.
Lil Gus.
Bo Derek.
Ooh. Okay.
With the braids. Yeah. With the braids. Yeah. With the cornrows.
I mean, that's probably my first like celebrity.
Now coming out of the water.
You was running on the beach, weren't you? In your mind. Tell the truth. You was running on the beach.
What about Baywatch then? With the slow-mo Pam Anderson?
Damn it.
No. Who's the one with the nipples? Farrah Fawcett in the red bathing suit? I mean, we all have nipples. Sorry.
Guys have nipples too.
Some nipples more famous than others.
All right, number three, I'm gonna go with Miss Jennifer Aniston.
Ooh, Jennifer Aniston. Okay,
she could be my friend.
She's that wholesome girl next door.
See what I did there?
I saw what you did there. I'm just surrounded by quick-witted people, man. I can't keep up with these two.
Number four is a product from South Africa. Do you know who I'm talking about?
Charlize Theron.
Kunta Kinte. What y'all know about Kunta Kinte?
His name is not Toby.
Charlize Theron.
She's gorgeous. Oh, she's a classic beauty. Yeah. She's a classic beauty.
And so many different roles and just, that's it.
No, she's gorgeous.
She is.
I love her.
And number five, and this is one that's not up there on a lot of people's like beauty lists and what, but I don't know, there's something about her from a long time ago, Diane Lane. That's one of the ones.
She was wearing her hair, right?
And Denise gets annoyed by it.
She was in a bunch of Woody Allen movies.
Any movie we see, she's like, I know. I'm like, okay, I'm sorry.
Right.
But she's in my five.
I don't think she's on anybody's top five list, man, except yours. But no, she's a pretty lady.
Exactly.
But she's like pretty next door type.
She's fat. P-H-A-T.
Right.
Pretty hot and
1996
tempting.
Right.
Pretty hot and tempting.
Right. They want your terminology back. Right. Stupid with two O's.
They quick with it, man. That's a good top five, man. All right, man. Hey, can I do an honorable mention?
Sure.
Honorable mention.
Apollonia Purple Rain.
Oh, my God, yes.
Purple Rain.
Is she your sex shooter?
Purple Rain, man. Sex shooter. Oh.
She is fine as hell. Hey, tell me. Listen,
she's
let me
gorgeous.
Tell you something.
She's gorgeous.
Let me tell you something, man.
Like,
that movie is a classic.
That's a great movie. That's one of the best musicals. I can't believe I didn't think about that movie when I was naming all my musicals.
Could be our top five musicals.
Yeah, I love that musical.
Now,
so good.
I went to that bar.
Really?
In Minneapolis. Now, in the movie, it looks huge. I'm not kidding. That bar is small.
Did you
cleanse? It is like small. The stage. I'm like,
baby.
But they got like, it's like a rock bar, but they got pictures of Purple Rain all through it.
But
yeah,
and to even
awesome.
Get in, it's a big ass line to even get into that.
Did you cleanse yourself in Lake Minnetonka?
I took a piss in there. Took a piss in Lake Minnetonka.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Listen, man, I'm a boater. When we in the sandbar, we all pissing. Why do you think their water's so damn warm? Y'all know what I'm talking about? Anyone that's a boater. And you standing in the sandbar, you'd be having a conversation and shit. You'd be peeing on someone. Feel all.
You're not supposed to say that out loud.
You're not supposed to, but you be thinking
knows
it, though.
But you're not supposed
everyone,
to
you're
say
not,
it.
You're not supposed to say it out loud, but this shit happens.
Definitely don't say it while it's happening. It's don't be where, like, if you feel a warm spot.
It's probably where the first case of corona came from. I ain't lying.
I'm done.
I'm not lying.
You know,
man.
I feel like it also depends how much you drink. Because earlier in the day, people use the lavatory or the head or go off to the docks, and as the day progresses and the more booze you drink, the more you have to pee, the more fun you're having, the more likely you are to just say fuck it, I'm surrounded by everyone else's pee anyways, and just let her rip.
I'm drunk and high.
I mean,
I'm drunk and high, fuck
middle
it
of the, day,
the fish peeing there
all
anyway
the way over there. The
fish are peeing in the water all the time.
All the time.
And pooing. What about whale poo? Did you know whale poo is worth a lot of money?
God. Is it really?
It really is. It's like super rare.
How do you know that?
Because I looked it up. Because one of my best friends is like super afraid of whale poo.
How we go from top five celebrity crushes to whale poo?
Right. Apollonia to whale poo. That's what happens. That's what happens. You bring Katie in the mix, you never know what the hell is going to happen.
What the hell is going on?
That's what the hell is going on.
It's true.
That's another Patrick.
Dang.
Where is Pat?
Well, Pat was here last night.
Oh, yeah.
Who's here? The mayor, Patrick. Sat your ass down.
He's a night drinker.
He's a night drinker.
Hey, so before we introduce our special guest.
Special guest.
Very special guest.
Very special guest.
I want to ask you a question.
What's the question?
So it's about our viewer emails.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Where the hell are they?
Yeah, where are viewer emails?
You can email, message you, message.
I do get some DMs.
Well, yeah. So what have you gotten? What kind of feedback have you got?
So people actually love. They actually love the show. So I got a lot of feedback on Katie. Actually, she actually.
Of course.
She did. She got the most, both male and females.
I was gonna comment
love
on
Katie.
That, but then I got high.
And then I got high. But Katie's like the X Factor, man. She has a great, you know, just a great vibe and everything. So she actually has gotten the most feedback, but everyone has given positive feedback on all of us. Yourself, me, but mainly Katie, man.
That's why we bring
they
her.
Say, they
That's
say,
why
hey,
we bring her back.
They say, hey, man, can she show us some tatas? I was like, man, ain't that type of podcast, you motherfucker. But I'll ask.
That's on the premium.
But I'll ask.
That's on the premium Snapchat.
But I'm gonna ask. Right. Members only. Hey, so tell me what is up with the members only? Like, this shit's so popular now.
I have no idea.
I think we should start one with Katie.
With Katie.
We're all stars now.
In
the dope show. We might make some money. Podcasts go through the roof.
Wow.
Katie, all of a sudden don't know who we are. I don't need you motherfuckers no more.
I got my own. I got my own.
But, hey, man, we got some great feedback. And for everyone that's following us right now, thank you very much, man. We appreciate the support. We've been getting a lot of love.
You know, one of the things I like about doing this, because I enjoy, you know, hanging out with you.
Oh, likewise,
bro. Drinking a little beer, eating some wings.
Cheers.
Jelly.
Now it's my turn. Look at that shit.
You got the drinking problem?
Right. Now I have a drinking problem.
But I also enjoy a time, again, because one of these bars we come to, Miss K's got some regulars, got some friends we made.
Right.
I'd like to bring them in.
Can we bring them in now?
The black of the berry.
The sweeter the juice. Ladies and gentlemen, my man Theus. Ladies and gentlemen. We're
bring Theus in here.
Appreciate y'all, man. Appreciate
it, brother. What's
How
up, brother?
Good, man. God bless.
God bless, man. How you doing, man?
Good to see you.
All right, man.
What you drinking?
Gus? Man, 312 brought to you by Katie right here.
Brought to you
right
by Katie.
All these were brought to us by Katie.
All these are brought to us by
Katie. I appreciate y'all, brothers, having me today.
Hey, man, likewise, man. We appreciate you. But like Gus said, a regular of Kitties. A good brother, someone that's always here. I met you here.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Same.
I really enjoyed the previous podcast. I wanted to rehash the top five you have, MC.
Oh, top five MC.
I'm
going straight in.
Well, wait, I got something else top five I want from you. Because
okay.
Theus, last year he finally wrote me into his fantasy basketball league.
It's the man that won the league, y'all, right here.
Ah, okay.
In fact, $200.
Okay. So that's why he mentioned it.
Okay. Exactly.
Right.
I got you. I was
hesitant, and I'm like, okay, and then got paid.
Got paid. Right here. We made the video right here.
So
right.
I do want to hear your top five MCs, but
okay,
I know you're big into basketball because a lot of our discussion in the chat's all basketball.
Right. So you talking about top five right now?
Right now or all time? Which one do you want? I want to go all time.
I'm going to go all time too.
Top five all time.
My favorite of
What's
the
your
best,
favorite all time?
All time.
What's your favorite and why?
I guess just all time. I guess number one would be Jordan.
Of course.
Not a big fan of Jordan, but I.
Come on now, dog. Come on, man.
Respect.
Agreed. He's all, like all.
I'm not a fan of Jordan. I'm not. Y'all know that. But I think
How
that.
How can you not be a fan of Jordan?
Right. I'm just not a fanboy.
Come on now, dog. Come on, man.
I think you got Jordans on. Don't you got some Jordans on?
No, I got some Walmart imitations on.
Come on now, dog. Come on, man.
That's a Walmart Jordans.
$10.99 for the low. Walmart fake Jordans. 84s, 86s.
Those are Johnsons.
John Paxson's.
John Paxson.
Yeah.
Michael
Johnson. BJ Armstrong, shout out. I'm not a fanboy of Jordan, but I thought the competition he went through and the legendary players he defeated. Right. So I'll go with Jordan 1. I'll say.
Did you watch the ESPN thing?
Yes, I did. Yeah, I thought it was very well done.
Last Dance.
How?
What was your opinion on it?
I think it. Hopefully, it brought. I mean, again, I Jordan's in my list too. And
number one for me.
Just in what he went through. Again, it's a different NBA. I hate the comparison. Like, is it LeBron? Is it Kobe? Is it Michael, because it's a different time, because you can even go farther back than that, but like,
right,
just that series that they did against the Pistons, I can't imagine any other player getting his beat up like that,
right?
And then still be like, okay, that's how you want
to
play.
You can't do that
today's
NBA. Not at all.
So,
okay,
yeah, number just to be two. Brief, I think just from the competition he went through, all the legendary players that he overbeat in the finals and the playoffs. Number two, I'd have to go with Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Okay.
Just
Lou Alcindor.
Yes, sir. Lou Alcindor.
Roger Murtaugh. What was his name in Airplane?
Airplane. That's
my,
right.
My name is Roger. So.
Yeah. The big afro, right?
What was his name when he fought Bruce Lee in the Game of Death? What the hell was his name? Tall and Sexy.
Tall and Sexy.
That's what they call you, don't they?
Tall and Sexy.
I took the name from
Kareem.
They call you
Tall and Sexy.
I took it from Kareem, brother. Yes. They call me Sexual Chocolate now, but back in the day, they used to call me Tall and Sexy.
Tall and Sexy.
Oh, man. Yeah, I'm going to go Kareem, too. Number three, that's a tough one, bro. I'm going to have to go. I got to go in order?
No.
All right,
so no order after that. I'm just going to say Mike, Kareem.
Not who you think is the best, just who's your favorite.
Who's your favorites, right?
Oh, my favorite. That's a different list, then.
Oh,
we got to start over this, man.
Oh, damn. Y'all killing me. I'm going to do the best. I'm going to do who I think is the best. I'm going to go Jordan. Kareem. Rest in peace, Kobe.
Rest in peace, Kobe. Rest in peace, Kobe.
GG, everybody.
GG, right.
I'm going to say, and then get no order, I'm just going to go with LeBron. And I got a sleeper for you, Hakeem Olajuwon.
Oh, he no sleeper.
Nigerian
I'm just
going to
say, that's in my top five.
Nigerian Nightmare was the football player.
Christian McCoy, my bad.
Super Bowl champs, right. Chiefs. Everybody in CB Omaha, right. Chiefs fan, Chiefs Nation.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got the lovely Katie.
Katie back, y'all. Katie. Shout out to Katie.
Thank you.
Shout out to Katie and Marilyn Manson and her videos.
Thank you.
What was Hakeem's nickname?
Thank you.
The Drink.
I thought he had like Man, I feel stupid now.
Nigerian Nightmare, Christian McCoy.
Christian McCoy.
Chiefs, Super Bowl champions, baby. Patrick Mahomes.
Not with Christian McCoy.
Not with Christian McCoy.
Right. He's 95 years old right now.
That motherfucker's old as fuck. but Hakeem is no sleeper. He's on my list.
Yeah. Can I give you my list for 4 years?
Absolutely.
Yeah, you can. Michael's on there.
Michael Jordan.
I can't. You can't. Somebody my age, Michael's on everybody's list.
You about 27?
You own a pair of Jordans?
Something like that.
20. You got a pair of Jordans?
You know Robert Parrish?
You know, because I want to say something.
Right.
Because I'm an aunt.
Right.
So Nike actually has this program, and it's called One Shoe Bank.
Right, you told me about that.
I can get a free shoe every year. I play wheelchair basketball and stuff, and that's what I call my. I get a basketball shoe every year. And this
they
year.
They give you one shoe a year.
One shoe.
What they do with the other
You got
shoe?
A deal?
Free.
You got your name on the side of it?
No. All right. No. But
So are you like the Michael Jordan of amputees?
Not at all. Not at all.
You got a shoe deal, though.
I'm somewhere there. I'm like the Horace Grant. Somewhere down there. I'm somewhere. I've had some of my moments, but I'm not like.
You're not
but
the star.
Anyway.
He's going to be on the first dance.
This year I got a Jordan, which is pretty cool. Uh-huh. I've gotten a KD shoe.
Okay.
Kyrie, I've got LeBron. So, like they send out nice shoes, but it's one. So it's like people who don't need, like I said, not all amputees.
Amputees.
Not all of them like wear. You know, some of them don't wear prosthetics. I use it for what wheelchair sports. So
okay.
Anyway, so Michael's their number one, number two, and one of the few people that I've actually met in my life, and I was completely starstruck, was Dr. J.
Dr. J.
Okay.
Julius Erving, again. Did he have an afro at the time?
No, not really.
He was smooth.
This is in the, I don't know, about 10, 15 years ago.
Okay.
So I met him later.
I thought he was dope with the afro.
I guess so.
You know, Steph Curry right now, he's up there.
He's a Golden State fan, everybody.
I'm a Golden State fan. But like Steph, what he's doing is, I don't know, it's nuts. You know, he's taking the game to like a different.
Right.
Not like Michael, but he's still taking. It's a different. How many teams now? Like, their whole thing is run down, shoot threes, run down, pass, pass, shoot threes.
Right.
And he's right now is the best at that game. In my opinion.
He is.
My next two are gonna go because again, maybe not. I think they're all stars and you know Hall of Famers, but it's just like personal favorites. Charles Barkley.
Okay.
Round
of rebound.
Sir Charles bought me a beer in Houston one year.
Yes, sir.
Did he really?
Yeah. Because
Dilly.
Because I'm an amputee.
Right.
I play wheelchair basketball, and
right.
We've had a couple of times where we had these NBA and WBA like All-Star Classic games, and so we would fly in as part of the NBA experience. What I forget what they call it, like the fan thing. You know, we'd come in like a Thursday, and we'd have like our own All-Star game. And a lot of times, that's where I met Dr. J. That's where I met. You know, a lot of people. One thing about Bill Russell, he's again all time great.
Right.
Don't ask him for an autograph.
Don't do it.
Don't do it.
Will he slap the shit out you?
I don't know, but
I've heard he'll buy you a drink.
It's funny as hell because this guy come up and goes, "Mr. Russell," he goes, "I know you don't sign autographs, but I gotta take a picture." and Bill Russell looked at me like, you know, "Like, what do you think?" Kind of didn't rush off. But no, so Charles was like, we're at a hotel in Houston, and Charles was talking with Ron Harper. And I'll go ahead and I'll give you my number five right now. Daryl Dawkins.
Ooh, Chocolate Thunder.
Rest in
that
peace.
That was my nickname.
Chocolate Thunder. And mine is Sexual Chocolate.
White chocolate.
So they were there in Houston. And like Ron Harper, Daryl Dawkins, and Charles Barkley all was kind of sitting there. And it was cool. What was cool about those experiences, like you see those guys who you idolize on TV and whatnot. And they're just like talking like we are talking right now,
right,
between the three of them,
right.
But anyway, Daryl called me Big Buckets. Daryl gave me a nickname because he was like an honorary coach for us a couple of times.
Okay,
and he nicknamed me Big Buckets.
Big Buckets.
Okay. Big Buckets.
I like that.
Because we had one of a practice game and stuff. I had a decent game. I was getting some stuff. And
can we call you that?
Big Buckets.
Sure. Big Buckets.
He call you White Chocolate.
He graduated.
No, he didn't.
White Chocolate. Big Buckets.
So anyway,
how much you average a game?
I don't know.
You was in a 30 piece?
No.
You was giving 30 pieces
yeah,
like
Jordan, yeah, Jordan average.
I've done 30, but
yeah,
I
Jordan average
30 pieces out, huh?
Anyhow.
Okay.
So they get done talking. They get done talking up and he's walking around and I stood up and I go, "Daryl, it's me, Big Buckets." And he remembered me from like the year before or something like that. So we started talking and he introduced me to Charles and that kind of stuff.
What's up, man?
And then we were talking around and another buddy of mine, he started talking about the Bears, we like from Chicago, and he always comes on like Waddle and Sylvia on the ESPN 1000 here in Chicago. And so we're like talking, whatnot. Next thing he's buying drinks for people. Daryl Dawkins drank a chocolate martini.
Rest in peace, Daryl Dawkins.
Of course.
And then he's like, I'm gonna by him. He goes, and whatever this guy over here is drinking. I'm like,
big buckets.
Damn, big buckets just got
big buckets.
But yeah, it's, but like, then Daryl Dawkins is my number five, and that was, and one of the reasons I have a special place for him. Besides, I thought he was an awesome player, just a dominant guy. But
Right. Again,
the work he did with wheelchair basketball at NWBA, he really had a spot for us, and so he was always volunteering the honorary coaching.
Right.
Years where he wasn't necessarily even involved, he would still kind of come out and be involved and that kind of stuff. I mean, last time I saw him in New York, he was even, I saw him in the hallway, and we were talking for a little bit. He's like, hey, I'm going to my room. You see this guy come in, he's my uncle. Tell him to go to whatever room it was. I'm like, I'm passing along messages or something.
Right. You was just waiting. You was posted up waiting.
So, I mean, you know, that was, and again, right. it's just kind of cool.
How long did you wait to pass that message?
Oh,
it came in like, no, the guy came in like 15 minutes later. I'm like, okay. He's okay. Like, I'm like, hey, I go, Daryl's in room 5A.
He was like, oh man, Daryl was up. You try to sound all cool and shit. Oh man, Daryl up in the room.
And special honorable mention on that fear for just like somebody who's really good for what they do, like beyond the court, Felipe Lopez.
St. John's, baby. Guess that documentary.
See, that's why.
Had a flashback. Sorry.
No, like, yeah, he's really cool.
Theus is a sports aficionado.
Basketball guru.
Nah, hey.
Guru aficionado.
Sign 100%.
But that's my five, so.
Okay. Now, my turn.
Number one,
man, you already know, man.
Man.
I own maybe 70.
You own Space Jam, though.
162
pairs. I own at least 75 pairs of this man's shoes. Michael Jordan. Michael Jeffrey Jordan.
Okay.
Number one. Cheers. Yes,
cheers to that.
He's just the GOAT, man.
And a billionaire. One of the only
He is a billionaire. He's a billionaire. I'm on my way, but he's already there. I'm gonna see you, Mike.
Yep.
Number two. I gotta go with my man, rest in peace. Love you, brother. Kobe Bryant.
Yes, sir.
Black Mamba.
Man, you want to talk about a situation, man, that made me cry, just being a father of a beautiful young lady and just hearing all the stories, what happened with his daughter, Gigi. It broke my fucking heart, man. I swear to God. It killed me. And then it actually brought me and my daughter closer, because she was like, Dad, you know, that whole story reminded me of like me and you, and me and my daughter got real tight. Now she's back out hanging with her friends and shit.
And you know what? You know,
quarantine over, right?
What I didn't like about that, because Kobe had a little trouble in his history.
We all human beings, though.
Don't be a Gale King.
No, I'm not.
We all humans, man. Everybody makes mistakes.
Don't be a Gale King. We all got our own.
Everybody got demons.
Right. We all got demons.
I'm not. And I'm saying what bothered me wasn't that he did that, but it's like, everything he had done, from what all accounts, he had done so much after that fact to right the ship, to be a part, to be a good, a better husband, a better father, what he did in the community and stuff like that, what he meant to like so many people.
Right.
It's like I think that's sometimes what people do is they try to focus on the one little negative thing and they'll put that out.
Gale King.
And they'll put that out there. It's like, dude, he did a lot.
Oprah talked to her.
He did a lot of good.
But you got to think, guys. Warren Buffett had a saying: it takes 20 years to build your reputation.
Absolutely.
Shoots. 5 minutes to destroy your reputation.
Shoots and ladders.
So they will focus on that one thing. You do 99 things right.
But he,
right. One thing will tear all the 99 down.
But I thought, yeah, right. what that happened again. He's somebody close to our age, you know, and that thing. So, yeah,
right.
that hit hard. He's doing what he loved. He's trying to be a good father. He's, you know.
And he rebounded from it. That's the whole point. Yeah, so. You can come back from your fault.
Yeah, the RIP
fault.
He came back, man. A great father. A really good businessman.
Yeah.
I like Kobe, man. And the thing is, the interesting thing is, I used to root against him. Because I was never a big Lakers fan, but my cousin is the biggest Lakers fan of all time. And I used to always get on his ass. I was like, motherfucker, you ain't never even fucking been to L.A. How the hell are you a big-ass Lakers fan? He ain't never been to L.A.
That's what I was like. That's what I was like with Shaq. Everybody's like, "Oh, Shaq's so bad." I'm like, if I was like 7'4" or whatever the hell, and
400 pounds,
I would be dominant.
Damn near all muscle.
Can I go on a mini rant though? I'm going to. So you mentioned a good businessman, right?
Right.
And everybody hates on LeBron for what he does. I'm a big LeBron fan.
Okay.
So they hate on LeBron, but he ain't never once got a speeding ticket. Never once been in the news. Never once been in TMZ.
You don't even know who his wife is because she's behind the scenes, right?
I know his wife.
But my thing is,
I just see her.
I don't know her like that.
I'm just saying.
Wait, are we going to have like a Jada Pinkett Will Smith moment right here?
I'm saying.
We'll talk about that.
I know his wife because
I got a little bit of information on the whole Jada Pinkett, but we'll talk about that later. But
all I'm saying is
LeBron has a beautiful family.
But this man built a school in his hometown. I mean, give away, he does, but everybody hates on him for what reason? You would be the perfect role model, right? Steph Curry would be the perfect, but everybody, the media, depicts these stories because they want to hate on these guys. These guys, LeBron ain't never been in the news, been arrested.
And I don't
17 years in the limelight, never, you ain't never seen him out of the club getting a fight.
What LeBron does off the court, I got nothing but respect for.
Come on, man.
You know, but again, like I said, a couple of those on my list just because I had personal experience with them.
Right.
You know, but like, I think for me, with LeBron and stuff, who's top five, top 10 all-time talent.
Sure.
You know,
no doubt.
I'll give him that.
Yeah.
But it's like just, you watch the last dance and how LeBron plays. I never saw like Jordan flop. You know, and again, my critique of LeBron is just, you could be so dominant, and yet he takes some of the flopping, or he takes the...
Right.
That's me. But what do I know?
And the thing is, he didn't have that killer instinct like a Jordan.
I don't think he got a killer instinct.
I've seen him disappear.
I think he looks for help.
I remember that time I remember when he played in Cleveland, and he was playing against San Antonio, and they got swept. He disappeared in that
series. Michael never got swept.
Oh, no.
Ever.
No.
Very true.
Michael Jordan's the GOAT, bottom line. But I do respect LeBron.
Yeah. Is he in your top five? Let's get to number three.
Well, number three.
That's
it's what my man Theus had mentioned him. Man, I love this brother, man. Akeem, the Dream, Olajuwon. Listen, man, I remember he made Shaq look like he was in grade school.
And David Robinson.
He made them dudes look like... Because not only did he have a great post-up game, he had handles and a jump shot, man. Yes, sir. I mean, the
black of the berry, the sweeter the juice.
That's why we're
coming to America, baby.
The three putzes.
The reason we're laughing at this, man,
I throw them off with
that. That is Theus's calling card, man. That's he'll come out of nowhere and say that shit. I mean, you ain't even expecting it. It cracks me up like it's the first time
I
heard it.
What did Katie say?
What's up,
the darker the flesh, the deeper roots.
You're like, what's up, this? Darker the berry, sweeter the juice.
Darker the berry, sweeter the juice. Okay.
Like, how you doing?
Roots. Right.
Darker the berry, sweeter the juice.
Yes, sir.
That means everything's good.
And Thea says that shit all the time, and it catches me off guard every time.
I just like I just did now.
Every time, it catches me off guard. But I love it.
So who do you have for number four?
Number four, man. And for the Hood Brothers, man.
Ooh.
They already know who this is.
You're gonna say Ron Artest.
Oh, Ron Artest.
Meta World Peace.
No, but I do like him.
Ready for the world.
No, man, y'all forgot about AI, Allen Iverson.
Oh.
Man, come on, man. AI, Allen Iverson.
Can I give you a little story?
Give me a story, man. Right.
Yeah, I know. So at one of these events that we're at, and we hear the thing where he like
Katie doing that with her
Katie
leg
doing
right
that
now.
Her leg.
We need to turn the camera over.
Turn the camera. Fans only.
Fans
only. They're going to edit this, man. They're going to edit this.
We not in shit.
So again,
fans only. Katie, go ahead. And
what you said?
Torque that leg. Torque that leg.
Cat go coming out to intervene.
But it
you guys
why did she just remind me of Sharon Stone?
Oh!
I was about to say the same thing. I swear to God, I was about to say the same thing. Katie over here doing this in a dress.
Y'all could at least say Michelle Pfeiffer from Batman or something better.
You know what? Forget about my Allen Iverson story.
Forget what he just said, y'all.
Listen, I was thinking the same damn thing, I swear to you. That's so
man,
funny.
Man, oh man. All right.
So number five.
You guys going to give us an AI story?
Yeah, yeah.
Nah, that's she ruined the moment.
I'm gonna give you my favorite five. But you give me your fifth.
Okay. Well,
he went to the best.
AI man, I just love him, man. He was
I don't know, man. I just first of all, he was dope.
He was a trendsetter, right?
He was a trendsetter. He was dope, man.
He was what?
And he had that. Oh, he had that attitude about him, right?
For the culture, man. Attitude.
Yeah, for the culture.
100%. Migos.
Okay.
Number five.
Scottie Pippen.
Oh, stop it.
Scottie Pippen over LeBron James.
Who's your honorable mention?
Now.
I'm going to bypass that Scottie Pippen comment.
Listen, man.
No tipping Pippen. Chicago know it.
Scottie Pippen, man, with the world famous
migraine
historical
headache.
Chicago Bulls.
Oh, God. Spare me.
Hey, man, the migraine headache came before the championship runs.
But Scottie is amazing. And I want to take
Look, they're trying to down me on my
Pippen. I'm going to give you why he's not in mine.
Ain't nobody ask you, Gus.
Tony Kukoc.
Kukoc is cold.
Hold on.
He's cold.
Are you high?
No. I'm not saying Tony Kukoc is better.
You're high right now.
I'm not saying Tony Kukoc is better.
You haven't dabbled in medical marijuana.
He's good.
But I'm saying the coach call a play.
Oh, the one play. What you just said.
In 15
one
years.
One play. What?
But
right?
Hey, that's, like you said, one moment.
And that was
shining moment.
That was during the years that Michael had retired.
Right. And I can understand, like, you think I'm the man. This should be going through me. I understand you being like a little upset,
right?
But where you just like, fuck it, I ain't playing.
Right.
I could never do that.
What would you do as a leader in that situation?
Let me tell you something, man. Gus did that shit to me one time.
Yeah, at Miss Kitty's.
He wanted the first mic, and I said, man, I'm gonna take the first mic. You take the second mic.
They sing.
He walked
girl,
off the stage and said, I quit.
I'm not even gonna sing.
Whiskey
he said,
girl.
I ain't gonna even sing. I said, but you the main singer.
He was a background dancer, like J-Lo
so
and Living Color.
I gave him the first mic.
Hey, man, one mic.
So, I couldn't be standing up
one
there
mic,
just.
One love.
I couldn't be standing up there just singing a hook. That shit when, you know, just, and then all of a sudden,
you seen the hook.
A whole minute go by, and all of a sudden, lovely day, lovely day, lovely hey. Day, lovely. Everybody's, that boy good.
Hey, before we have to cut for the next section.
Yeah.
I do want to get his top five. Was it top five MCs?
Yeah, I'll do it real quick.
Top five MCs.
All right. So, yeah, let's get back to.
Shout out to Katie. Her favorite player was Dennis Rodman.
Her favorite player definitely Dennis Rodman.
She's going to add the latest perspective at the end of this commentary.
Ooh, Dennis Rodman, Madonna, Carmen Electra.
His list is legendary.
I mean.
Carmen Electra was fine.
If you want to go by, like, my top. No, never
mind.
Mama
fine, too.
Yeah.
Right.
My mama fine too.
Talk that truth.
Oh, I love this song, man.
Top five MCs.
If y'all don't know in the background, they got MTV Jam, like Bill Bellamy and Dan Cortez in the background. Yo, MTV from '93.
But they're playing Alanis Morissette.
Man, Alanis Morissette. That shit is dope.
So I'm gonna get to my top five all time. My favorite.
I like when she says chicken shit.
Chicken.
I'm serious. That's my favorite part of that song.
Whoa. Chicken shit.
My top,
am
my,
I,
my
am
favorite
I wrong?
Five.
I love that fucking part of that song.
I'm trying to get the Gus. I'm trying to get out of here.
That's right. It's the best part of that song.
Yes, sir.
This song's dope, dude.
Man. Anyway.
That song is dope, dude.
That's what we need to do, a top five. Like our
I got one hand in my pocket. And the other one, I don't know the words of shit.
Come on, Atlantis.
I just know
singing girl.
Shit.
That, you know, we need to do like a top five like
hey.
Most. Like least liked singers,
least liked
or song.
You got to, hey man,
okay.
But anyway, right now though, we're getting his top five MCs.
We'll get Theus's top
you doing
five
MCs. I'm biased, so I'm just gonna go Bone Thugs and Harmony off
I thought
top.
You were Theus.
I am.
I'm
Theus.
Sorry, that's a bad joke.
Bone Thugs and Harmony off top. My number one all time favorite.
Bone Thugs. Okay.
Bone Thugs, my favorite individual, Notorious B.I.G. Rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
Same birthday as Katie mosdef. IG, Facebook, Snapchat. Number three, Jadakiss.
Ooh, Jada.
Jadakiss lyrically.
Knock yourself out.
Why? Whatever. Number four.
You like Jadakiss with the locks?
Yeah, you know, shout out to Sheik Lute, shout out to, you know, Ghostface, everybody like that in New York. He was P. Diddy's backup dancer. People don't remember that.
Who was?
Jadakiss.
He was P. Diddy's backup
dancer?
He
was a backup dancer on Bad Boy.
You know, P. Diddy was a backup dancer.
P. Diddy was a back to
yeah,
Heavy D,
to
right?
Heavy D, and then he was
or
producer.
Or Big Daddy Kane.
Yeah, and Big Daddy Kane.
To who?
True that, Big Daddy Kane.
Big Daddy Kane, my top five.
His top five. We need to get that rehashed again.
Here I am.
Bone Thugs.
R-A-W, a terrorist. Here to bring trouble to phony MCs that go on in season. Just conquer and sup another rapper with ease.
I'm
at my apex and others all be low.
He's flashing back to win. See, like Katie and I got, like, spit on.
You got spit on by who? Marilyn Manson?
No. Marilyn Manson.
Lazy Bone threw his water bottle on me.
Katie got licked by Marilyn Manson. She slobbed her down, dude.
I got Jason Newsted from Metallica.
She just made it G-rated, dude.
He got the mic from Big Daddy.
You got a mic from Big Daddy King?
I swear to you.
In 2000.
I'm going to show you.
Ain't no half stepping.
Huh?
Ain't no half stepping.
Yeah, ain't no half stepping.
Ain't no half stepping.
Come on, tell
them. Ain't no half stepping.
Have you ever had any like interaction with anybody in a concert like that?
I saw Chingy. I shot Isaiah, me and Chingy. We ran up on Chingy in Lincoln, Nebraska.
There you go.
He opened up for Snoop, and it was a weird. He came through the wrong door. Hey, look, Zay, you see this? You remember this? Chingy came through the wrong corridor, and we was right next to him in the popcorn line. And then the big girl said, "Oh my God, that's Chingy!" And then it all hell broke. Zay, you remember that, dog? Yeah, I'm sorry, I lost control. Hey, we was right next to Chingy right here, me and my cousin Zay.
Yeah.
And then the big girl ran at him and it was all over. 400 big girls ran at him. I thought they was running to me, but I didn't know what was going on.
All right, were you at number three or number four?
Three. Jada Kiss is three. Right. Four, this is my sleeper and one of my, always my favorite, Nappy Roots.
Ooh.
I love Nappy Roots as a band behind Bone Thugs.
You like Jimmy Fallon?
Who?
No, that's The Roots.
That's
my man. Yeah. That's like two.
Come on now, dog. Come on, man.
That's like two mistakes. I did Nigerian Nightmare, right. And I'm like Nappy Roots and The Roots. Right.
Again,
hey, but Black Thought is dope, though.
I'm sorry.
Black Thought.
I'm
sorry. Pitch Black. You remember Pitch Black?
I do not.
What about Slum Village?
I'm off my
Slum
game.
Slum Village, yeah.
Slum Village, they all dead, though.
Are they really?
Like two of them. All right, I'm sorry. I'm getting off topic, y'all. So, Bone Thugs, Notorious, Jadakiss, Nappy Roots.
Yeah.
Number five. Damn, I'm gonna go with Nas.
Nasir Jones.
I'm go with Nasir.
Nasir
five.
Jones.
Honorable mention, of course. No disrespect, Tupac. I love him. Same thing with Jordan. Not a, you know, just always grew up listening to him. So Pac always got to be there. Okay. Not really honorable mention, but just in there. So, Gus, OG.
You know something, man?
You never Ice Ice Baby?
Why you got to throw Vanilla Ice at me?
Hey, man, you the mix.
Although I do admit I have a Vanilla Ice t-shirt.
Oh, Lord.
We knew it.
Mercy.
We knew it.
We knew it.
Well, but he was touring with Hammer.
You got a white chocolate jersey at home from the Kings?
No, but he was touring with Hammer. I forget who all was in it. It was Vanilla Ice, MC Hammer. And I don't know if that was the same. I saw a couple concerts back in the day. Bell Biv DeVoe and Vogue.
Okay, Bell Biv DeVoe. You really doing something.
But I can't. I think Hammer was with Vanilla Ice and someone else. Yeah, and I just got a Vanilla Ice t-shirt because at the time, before Rob Van Winkle was really known.
Right. But look, man, let's go ahead and just clear this shit up.
It ain't Milli Vanilli shit.
Well, let's clear this
Milli
shit
Vanilli.
Up.
Milli Vanilli, what?
Back in the day, a lot of motherfuckers like that Ice Baby song.
Everybody liked that
song. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle movie. It was on that. It was featured on Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Lose that. Get with the hero. Lose that zero.
It's like when he got really, really like big and popular, and all of a sudden, we hate this motherfucker.
Well, again, because it come out like what he like represented himself as.
Right.
It wasn't quite on the up and up. Wasn't hard. He was like.
Right.
Again, he wasn't Ice. When Vanilla Ice, he was Rob Van Winkle.
Right, he kind of like how Drake is. Drake
he changed hard. When Suge put him over that balcony.
Drake ain't hard. I whoop Drake ass. Tell him I said.
Is that light skin on light skin crime?
I know I could whoop Drake ass.
Light skin on light skin crime. I hope
you had a good Canada Day yesterday.
Happy Canada Day, Catherine.
And I like
Canada.
And I like Drake. Don't get me wrong.
Sorry, I lost control, y'all.
Theus.
Yes, sir.
And I do like Drake.
Sorry.
Don't get me wrong.
But what about
10
J. Cole?
Bands,
what about
50
J.
Bands,
Cole?
100
J.
Bands.
J. Cole or Kendrick Lamar right now?
Shit.
J. Cole or
Tribe Called Quest.
I actually mentioned that to him the other day because
as an honorable mention.
Yeah, that's that was good. Yeah. I saw that doc.
What about Ghetto Boys?
Here we go, yo. Here we go, yo. So what? So what? So what's the scenario? Here we go. Oh, that's it. But the dopest verse on that, Busta Rhymes.
I'm saying.
You know,
Busta, Busta on that.
You know what? One of my
the coldest rappers from Jamaica, ain't it? Busta. You know, Biggie Smalls from Jamaica.
One of my favorite groups, and not for the song you think it was.
Yeah, it's Mama.
Digital Underground. I think Digital Underground is underrated.
Do you like?
Tupac was in Digital
besides Humpty, exactly.
Humpty Dance. So you probably like Get Around.
Get Around.
What was the movie they was in?
Step up. Step up.
What was that movie?
Step up. Step up.
What was the movie they was in?
Step up. Step up.
What was that movie?
Step up. Step up.
What was the movie they was in?
Step up. Step up.
What was that movie?
Step up. Step up.
How you doing? So you'll be here, but I was.
It was Chevy Chase.
Yeah, Digital Underground. I love like Sex Packets was a great album.
That was
not just Humpty Dance.
Yeah, it was.
I mean, do what you like.
Here's your chance to do the hump.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, Shawna, baby.
Do the. I wish the camera was on Katie.
I'm the one that said just
Katie got a fans only. She got a fans only over here, man. Katie, keep moving that dress around.
Katie's dress on here. Look at. You need to show them the full dress, Katie.
Talking about Tupac's speedo. He had his little shit hanging out. You know, Digital Underground.
She gonna come out with a cameo codpiece going on. She gonna come out with a codpiece going, word up.
Cameo?
Yes.
Yeah.
Out of control. Out of control.
It's out of control. It's out of control.
But y'all, I appreciate y'all brothers having me on today, man.
Oh, man, we appreciate
you. You know what I mean? I'm a fan first.
We appreciate you being here, man.
I want to put it out. Can I put it out there?
Go ahead, man.
I want Silent D. I'm putting it out there.
Yeah.
Big Dwayne.
Silent D.
I want the Dwayne and Burton conversation.
Requested.
Right. And I'm waiting for the granddaddy.
Right.
The master of
P. Diddy.
Patrick P. Newell.
The mayor.
Chicago legend.
The mayor.
That's what I'm saying.
The mayor.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, P. Newell, we waiting for you.
It'll be the highest views ever for Patrick.
It would be. Can you give us your saying before you depart?
The blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice.
Sweeter the juice, baby. Ladies and gentlemen.
Happy Thirsty Thursday. Ladies and gentlemen. Sexy chocolate. That boy good. I love your Council Bus, Iowa, Omaha, Nebraska. Go Huskers.
Hey, we need, what you doing? What you doing?
Listen, man.
All right.
If I could sing, this is who I would be. You know who this is? You got my mirror? Shit. You know you feeling that, Gus? You feel that, Gus?
It's a Minneapolis song.
It's a Minneapolis song. But this is what I would say to the ladies. What's your phone number?
That boy is good.
Good and terrible.
God damn, that boy can sing.
You must be crazy.
He good.
You must be crazy.
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.